Can you believe it's already Tuesday?
And a week away from Election Day.
Just 7 days.
It is 1 week until Election Day.
Exactly 1 week until Election Day.
Exactly a week until Election Day.
Exactly 1 week until Election Day.
1 week until Election Day.
1 week to Election Day.
1 week until Election Day.
1 week until Election Day.
1 week until Election Day.
1 week. And we can go on and on and on. Yes, it is 1 week till election day. Today is October 28, 2020, and the time right now is 8:02 p.m. And my name is Jonathan, and let's take a look at the market. And right now, Dow Jones down 480 over points. And if you take a look at the market right now, this is Dow Jones. Look at today's candle. Remember I said we break this candle? We're going to go lower. Look at S&P daily candle and look at Russell daily candle. But something weird is with Nasdaq. It didn't drop that much. Okay, so why? Mainly because we had a Microsoft earnings, but right now the main earnings will be this Thursday, tomorrow, okay, October 29th, where's the October 29th? October, let's go the weekly one. Okay, the major one will be Apple, Amazon, Google, Facebook. So that's what they are all hoping, that perhaps Nasdaq can still save the market. And why did the market drop so much? Mainly because of the flu again. Okay, so because of the flu resurgence and even stronger right now in the Europe, so a lot of Auntie Merkel this afternoon say they may have to do some lockdowns. So now with the record number of flu cases in United States, yes, testing, but doesn't that mean that there are more people getting the flu? Oh, well, I don't know what's the logic. Some people just don't have logic. Or maybe I should start to say that the earth is actually flat and the earth is round is all fake news. Oh, well, I never heard of doctor or nurses dying from wearing a mask. So who cares, okay? But right now, one thing you have to take note of. There will not be any lockdown, okay, in United States. Like it or not, Uncle Pence, very seldom I use his name, but he's an essential worker. He's supposed to be quarantined, but because he's an essential worker, he's just going around, and the number of cases are all over Uncle DJT rally state. So there can never be a lockdown, at least until the election. But then, after November 3rd, there's a lockdown. Then someone, if Uncle DJT wins, well, whether there's a lockdown, no lockdown, doesn't matter to me. Whatever I share is my personal opinion. If you like to trade, please do your own due diligence. But let's take a look at the market. This is VIX yesterday. We shot up higher. We never go below. So remember the Sunday YouTube, I said it must go higher, but too bad, didn't. So right now, everyone's going to look at Google earnings. See that? It's going, Apple earnings is going up, okay? You see, a lot of market are anticipating the news. Remember yesterday, the market was down. 2 days ago, the market was down. See here? S&P. See? We have been down 3 days. But look at the tech has been practically going up 3 days. Remember, I said Amazon on Sunday YouTube. Ta-da! Okay? Google didn't drop that much. Okay? Microsoft already announced. Okay, so basically, the market is now hoping that the tech will be good. iPhone 12, hopefully a lot of people has already booking, waiting for delivery. Everyone is going to watch all the numbers. Okay, so do remember one thing. If you're not in the Facebook Gathering of Trader, join Facebook Gathering of Trader, go to the files. A lot of people have been asking me about MoneyPot Lite Edition, the indicator. So go to files, Harami Candle and MoneyPot Lite. Why? Because this is the trade I took just now, this afternoon. this afternoon, and you can get this indicator by going to Facebook Gathering of Traders, Files, Harami, and Moneypot Lite. You get this indicator for free. Okay, took this trade, very nice. A few meals are practically paid for already. And if you are not in Telegram, join the Facebook Gathering of Traders. Not Facebook. Search by Telegram Gathering of Traders and like, share, and subscribe. If you don't want to share, never mind. Just tell your friends that, hey, you better look at Jonathan YouTube because that's where I talk about technical analysis. Okay? So let's talk about the market news. Market news. Lira. And this is Turkey Lira trade. Daily candle. And look at that trade. From 2016 till now. If I change this to a monthly chart, from 2014 till now, it just dollar Turkey Lira just surge higher, which means if this, that means Turkey Lira has been dropping and it is a record drop, mainly because of political. Okay, I'm not affiliated with anyone, I don't care, I just want to find out opportunity, make money. The only problem with this chart, Turkey Lira, the spread will be huge. Look at that spread. So if I take an example, some people ask me, can we take this trade? Look at that. Very nice 15-minute chart. Very nice 15-minute chart. And if you're going to assume a 1-to-1 risk ratio, that's the spread. Yeah, can make money, but bigger percentage of your spread goes to, bigger percentage of your profit goes to the spread. So which is why if you're going to trade this type of counter, that very big spread, you don't want to take too small time frame, you at least want to trade a bigger time frame like hourly, 4-hour or daily candle, where the percentage of the spread versus your candle is smaller. Okay, so apart from this, this is just a breakout, nothing to trade, right? Now, major news would be stimulus package, no more. Basically, Senate after dragging and dragging and dragging for the excuse of trying to talk about the stimulus package, the actual agenda is, I just want to drag the Senate until we confirm the Supreme Court judge. Then we bye-bye, because we now have to go to our own individual state and county, because we are going to have to rally for the coming November 3rd. Not only presidential election, but there's also Senate election and also House. But House, number of people that are being challenged are not a lot. So the House is still Democrat. Now looking for Senate to be Republican or Democrats and Uncle DJT or Uncle JB. So remember?
Until election day.
1 week 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 until election day.
Election day is 1 week from today. You believe?
Okay, believe that or not. Believe that or not. Okay, so now 1 week till election day. So let's take a look at the market right now. If we take a look, I'll close this. This was the Moneypot Lite. Okay, back to right now. If we actually had a rebound because of the FIBO 38, and now we broke that. And right now, as of right now, the time is 8:10 p.m. We are now at this, just now touched the FIBO 61%. So watching to see whether can we form a bullish candle somewhere today, or today, that means we have to recover right here. Perhaps if we can recover and change today's S&P candle to a white candle, we're going to have a bullish candle and got supported by the FIBO 50 and FIBO 61. More likely, it could be tomorrow where we opened somewhere here, have a sell down recover, then the support, the FIBO 61% support will be holding, and that's trading opportunity. So I'm watching the chart very closely right now, especially in S&P, mainly because we are now at that FIBO 61%. Plus, if you take a look at Dow Jones, if let's say it's tomorrow, we will be at the 200 support. Could it be that maybe we come up here and do something like this? Possible. So that's why today and tomorrow I'll be watching the market very, very closely. Okay. If we take a look, I'm just going to close this. If you take a look, okay, at the Germany major sell down over the last 3 days, practically we broke that support and the market just collapsed. So right now, a little bit more downside in Germany DAX right here at FIBO 38. Germany DAX FIBO 38 will be about 11,350, which coincide with this gap and coincide with this support and coincide with this resistance. So that number, 11,350, is a extremely important number for Germany DAX. Watching that very, very close, and perhaps we can reach there by tomorrow if the market continues to drop. And I'll be watching also very closely the world index, London. Okay, the London. If we can, if Germany DAX drop, London can reach FIBO 61. If S&P can recover, maybe by tomorrow, you'll notice that we will be at that FIBO 50 supporting, which is currently for London FTSE, will be at 56.20. So watching this number very closely. If we drop, then watching the 54.11. Now, if we take a look at US dollars, okay, US dollars flew higher. Well, market fearful, everyone jumps to US dollars, okay? Now, the thing is, gold go down. But did you notice that US dollar went up a lot more? Gold didn't go down a lot more. So in other words, overall in the chart is somewhat bullish. But if you are frustrated, I always like to chat with Bollinger. Look at that squeeze right there. So which is why every time you get frustrated, check the chart, check the Bollinger. If it's squeezing, now you know why you are frustrated, because it means that it is a sideways trend and there is no trending. So that's why you cannot bias long, bias short. You will have to trade fast in, fast out, fast in, fast out. Long at support, short at resistance, long at support, short at resistance. Okay, so which is why that's a very easy way to understand. Okay, plus if you take a look, this looks like a horse pattern. A very old horse pattern. Okay, so oil also collapsed, because if you remember the last time, let me show you history. If you remember down here where the oil went negative for the very, very first time, oh, Dow Jones, I'll show you the chart in a short while. When oil went negative for the very, very first time, that's because everyone said because of the flu, the demand will no longer be there and there's way too much supply. That's why now with Europe having a higher cases, the fear comes back that oil price will collapse. And oil price right now is at this resistance. And this resistance is a very dangerous resistance, very dangerous support, because it is a lower high. So if we have a bounce, a technical bounce from here, lower high, form a descending triangle, good opportunity to short. Just now that signal was on hourly card. Hourly. Ta-da! Not a nice one. I'll prefer if the size is bigger. So you ask how to know a big one. Find a nice one previously, and you know that's the size you need to compare. Okay, so that's the money pot light that will alert you whenever you found a bullish candle or a bearish candle in any time frame, and you can get it for free. So till next week.
Election Day, 1 week away. Can you believe it?
1 week until Election Day. Can you believe it?
Election Day. Can you believe a week from today?
1 week until Election Day. Can you believe that?
Can you believe Election Day is 1 week from today?